from WLWT, this is Issues.
Hello, welcome to Issues. I'm Jan Michelle Lemon Kearney of SESH Communications and the Cincinnati Herald. We have such a fantastic show today. We're going to do some theater stuff. We've got a little clip from Dreamgirls that you won't want to miss. We're also going to talk about financial freedom and how you can get on the path to financial freedom and not worry about debt and bill collectors, and it's not gonna even cost you a penny. First, we're gonna stick with the theater theme, and we're gonna talk to Ken Early, and he is an actor with the Ensemble Theater Company in the current production of Red Velvet. Welcome, Ken, so glad you're here.
Thank you for having me, thank you.
So we're gonna talk a little bit about Red Velvet, but first, I wanna ask, how did you get involved in theater? Because you're a local person, you're from Cincinnati.
I am.
Yeah.
Yes. I started in the eighth grade, Dater Junior High School, actually. My English teacher, Miss Parnell, started me acting. She actually cast me in my first role.
Which was what?
Tom Sawyer.
Really?
Yes, the musical Tom Sawyer.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes, she was actually an African-American English teacher. And so she kind of got us hooked on literature.
And she took a real controversial play.
She sure did. Yeah. She did,
good
and
for,
she handed
good
it to
Ms.
me.
Parnell.
Yeah, that was my first time.
Okay, and so you were what part did you have in Tom Sawyer?
In Tom Sawyer, I played the lead, Tom Sawyer.
Oh, you were Tom Sawyer.
I was Tom Sawyer, yeah.
Wow, mm-hmm. Good for you. Mm-hmm. Okay, and so now you've continued acting. That sparked your interest.
That sparked my interest, and I stayed in it. I also went to the School for the Creative and Performing Arts.
Wonderful.
And so I was singing there, dancing and acting and everything there and stuff, but I didn't really think that this was going to be my profession, what my career was going to be.
Right.
You know, I knew I enjoyed doing it, but I didn't know that this was going to be it. And so after I graduated high school, I was 18, I went into the workforce. But around 1990, when I was 24, I got accepted into this College Conservatory of Music at the University of Cincinnati.
Wow.
So I went there for about 2 years and left from there, then went to NKU, and then left there in 96. So I didn't really finish anything, but my career has taken me to a place where I've always gone out and done the work.
That's fantastic.
Yeah,
that is so great. So you've had all that training and you just keep getting pushed back into theater. So we're really excited that you're in Red Velvet at the Ensemble Theater, professional theater, and that is such a great place. And all their productions are really awesome.
Absolutely wonderful. Yeah, I've been working there since 2007. That was my first time on their stage in an actual production in 2007.
Wow. Okay, so tell us about Red Velvet. What is Red Velvet about?
Red Velvet is about Ira Aldridge. He was the first African-American to play Othello on the European stage in the 1800s.
Wow.
So that was in 1833.
And we should let people know Othello was produced way before that, but it was always with a white actor.
It was always with a white actor in blackface.
Right.
You know, and so at the end of the play, I won't give it away, but it's very interesting what you'll see happen at the end of the play.
Okay, so it's about Ira Aldridge playing Othello.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah. and so your part is what?
I play Ira Aldridge.
So you're the superstar. That is so great. That is so great.
Yeah, I'm the featured actor in it, yes.
Wow. So, and I should let people, I want people to know that getting a part with the Ensemble Theater Company is not easy. I mean, you have to audition.
You have to audition, yes. Yes,
this
you
is
have
serious.
To audition. Yeah, it's very serious.
Yeah.
I mean, sometimes you get called in, you know, to read for a role, or sometimes you just call them and say, look, I'm very interested in this role.
Right.
And stuff, and so can I come in and audition for you? And Lynn is absolutely wonderful. D. Lynn Myers, who's the executive artistic director there.
She's phenomenal.
She is absolutely wonderful, and she has been such a huge support. Everyone down there, the whole staff, the creative team, everyone has been absolutely supportive. And I do want to say that my cast, the cast that I'm with, is absolutely fantastic, and they help me rise to, you know, the occasion of Ira Aldridge.
And that's so important.
It's very,
great
very
when you're
important.
Working with a cast you really like.
It's very, very important. Yeah. We all get along with each other and stuff like that. And then some of us have also done other shows together.
Okay. Oh, that's nice.
So
yeah.
It's actually two theaters really coming together to put this together. We have Brian Isaac Phillips, who's the director of Red Velvet, who's also the artistic director of Cincinnati Shakespeare Company.
I was going to say, I know Brian. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
He directed it. And so we have some people
good.
From his company and from Ensemble coming together to bring this
that's exciting.
Play to life.
Cincinnati has a lot of really great theater.
We have some great theater.
And I was going to say, Ensemble Theater Company is in such a cool area, right there in the gateway on Vine Street, near all those shops and cafes. And I mean, it's a fun hangout area.
It's absolutely wonderful. And all the theaters are about a block or two blocks away from each other. So we have No Theater, which is a block on Jackson Street.
Right.
And then two blocks up, we have Cincinnati Shakespeare Company.
Wow, that's so great. Okay, so tell us the dates for Red Velvet.
So Red Velvet, it opens tonight. So it's from the 7th through the 31st of March.
Okay, so actually by the time we air, it's going to be past the 7th. So it's open now. We'll just let people know.
Yes,
as you are hearing this taping, it is open now.
Right.
And it's open through, you said, March 31st.
The 31st of March,
okay,
yes.
Okay, and Ken, go ahead and give us all the information that's actually up on the screen.
So it opens tonight, March the 7th at Ensemble Theater Cincinnati, 1127 Vine Street. The tickets are $35 for adults, $28 for students, 12 years and under, $24. For more information, call 421-3555, extension 2105.
Okay, so give us that number one more time.
It's 421-3555.
Okay, extension 2105. And I know that Ensemble, I've been there a lot, and I've been there with groups too. They have group rates. Sometimes they have Q&A with the actors.
Yes. Yeah,
sometimes
we do.
They have, like, you know, wine and beer receptions in the lobby with the actors. I mean, there's all kinds of cool
stuff going on down there. And now with the new renovation, they have a bar and everything else like that, so people can just hang out.
I haven't been there since it's been renovated.
It's
and you're telling me the seats are better.
Oh, the seats are better.
I mean, like, you forget it. You forget about it once you're sitting there, but at first, like, the seats, like, wow, it's kind of like, you know, like, oh, we're high up here, but I understand the seats are bigger and there's more
much
room
better and then also it's the same configuration, but the only thing about it is that now you have handrails where you can actually walk up. Now you'll have to hold on to the sides of the seats or the
it's
back of the seats to get
place,
up
though.
It's a great place,
and the theater is just, I mean, it's very intimate, and you're right there, so I highly recommend that.
Please.
Thank you, Kim. We're going to all come out and see you Ira Aldridge in Red Velvet.
I think you'll all enjoy it.
All right. Okay, so we'll be back, but you're going to see a clip from Dreamgirls.
Have I known walking down that road? am changing, trying every way I can. I am changing, I'll be better than I am.
That brings tears to my eyes. That is Lacria Burns, and oh my goodness, just so fantastic from Dreamgirls. Let me introduce these two fantastic actors. Lacria Burns, you just heard her sing, and Fiona Capri.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Did I say your name right?
Got it perfectly.
Woo, yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, from Dreamgirls, tell us about the song, Lacria.
That's the moment in the show where Effie actually comes into the realization that. She's kind of grown up in the industry, and now she's really secure in who she is as a woman. She's a mother now. She's really left the dreams at this point, and she's on her own, and she's really kind of coming into her own. Wow. And she's telling the world, I'm here and I'm changing.
So I'm so excited that the Cincinnati Black Theater Company is doing Dreamgirls. You know, that is just, I mean, it won, you know, the show has won so many awards, the movie. I mean, it's just like all of it, you know, we saw Jennifer Hudson in the
yes.
role of Effie in the movie, and you are every bit as good as Jennifer, if not better. Oh my goodness. I mean, I'm just so impressed. And I was really just like shocked because you were saying, okay, you have three children, you're both Procter & Gamble, you know, corporate executives. Yeah. I'm like, so are you doing, you know, are you like on the, like out there on Broadway or what are you all, and you're like, no, we work here at P&G, so yeah. How does that work?
You just make it work. like we, she actually introduced me to Cincinnati Black Theater Company, and so this is my first production with them.
Wow.
But we just try to find time before or after work or during our lunch. We use our lunch to try to go through
You like meet in the P&G cafeteria yes. and go over lines.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. And we do most of the rehearsals after work after hours week. Or on the weekends.
Right, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much 24 hours we're singing in our heads.
Wow. Because it's really a lot of work. And that is, I mean, this production looks like it's going to be fantastic. Mm-hmm. So for people who don't know Dreamgirls, tell us a little bit about it.
Okay, so it is a pretty incredible story about three girls who come
kind of like the Supremes, like Diana Ross
yes.
and the Supremes.
Okay. And they kind of already have their own sound and their own look, and they're super young. They're in their teens, like 18, 19, 20. And they meet this car salesman, Curtis, and he changes their world, and he really changes the face of music for African Americans in the 60s and going into the 70s.
Right.
But he also kind of plays a little bit with my character, Effie, and Fiona's character, Dina, mm-hmm. as in a relationship. And he
right.
really pulls our friendship apart, and he changes the nature of our group dynamics. I used to be the lead. And he was my man first, and
right.
then he becomes her man, and she becomes the lead, and then.
He's kind of a Barry Gordy character.
He's definitely
right.
Barry Gordy.
Oh, okay. Jeff, you know what? Jeff has given us the wrap up. We could sit here and talk, and you know, oh my goodness. Let's tell people when it is. I know the number for the Cincinnati Black Theater Company is 513-241-6060, 513-241-6060. But you guys, give us all the information from the screen so people know where it's happening and how
yes.
to,
so
yeah.
So please come out, please come out and see us March 15th, 16th, 17th, and then the following weekend, March 22nd, 23rd, and 24th at Renew Community Church at 2129 West North Bend Road.
Right.
We look forward to seeing you guys.
Tickets are $30. That's Reverend Charlie Wimber, Pastor Charlie Wimber's church. So, and it's really, oh, the stage. I mean, there's a lot.
Incredible.
That's going to be wonderful. Okay, Jeff is saying we got to go. Thank you both of you so much for coming. Just, oh, so beautiful. And I can't wait to see both of you in Dreamgirls. Stick
you.
With us. We're going to get you on the path to financial freedom. Be right back. We'll be right back. Okay, so we are here with some big time folks from Fifth Third Bank, Bina Elliott, and she is Senior Vice President, Chief of Corporation Directors. I probably have the title. Give us your title, Bina. Let's get it right.
Okay. So I like to say that's a big title for
it's
what
a big
it,
title, but
for
you
what
do
really
a lot.
Matters is
no.
that I'm a bridge builder.
Okay.
Because when you think about what I do in my for the bank is I want to make sure that we are connecting with our communities and driving the right outcomes and really making sure that we're providing the right set of resources to help everybody build their wealth. So think of me, forget that title. Think of me as a bridge
but
builder.
But I want people to know she's Senior VP and we're really excited about that because we got to give her props. And we have another big wig. You guys know Mark Walton, VP also, and he is community. Give us your title.
Well, I'm the Director of Community and Economic Development for the Cincinnati region. So,
okay. So
what Bina does nationally,
right.
I do locally.
And that's so important because Fifth Third has made a huge commitment
Absolutely.
To Cincinnati and the region.
Yep.
So tell us about that. I mean, this is huge.
So I think you had me on the show earlier, late last year about it, but we made a $30 billion commitment.
$30 billion with
that's
a
what
B.
B. What
with
a B. B. And so we are really happy. We just got our second year results, and we've committed and spent and invested in our communities $14.5 billion
wow.
in the very first 2 years. And what more importantly than the numbers is what those numbers represent. Those numbers represent families and individuals that maybe got their first home, or small businesses that got access to capital to grow or start or expand their businesses, or projects in communities that were being able to be completed, and even commercial customers who are able to create or retain jobs.
That is so
great.
So
more than the dollars is what those dollars make a difference in our communities.
That is so great. Fifth Third is such a wonderful partner, definitely in Cincinnati and throughout the region. And I'm just, you know, just like so thankful you guys are so committed.
Mm-hmm.
So, but let's talk about Empower You, because the African American Chamber of Commerce, the Cincinnati Herald, and Fifth Third are joining together to present Fifth Third's Empower You. And we're going to get people on the path to financial freedom.
So just,
before it's all
we talk about
financial
about that,
fitness. Oh,
I
okay.
want to say thank you, because you brought us the idea of how to really engage our community differently. And we led off last year with two initiatives on small business and home ownership, and had great turnout.
People loved it.
And
yeah.
so it was the right thing to do to say, how do we continue to do that level of engagement and connect and educate folks? So once first say thank you to
you,
because it wouldn't have happened without you with the bright idea around how do we do a better job connecting.
Thank
and
you.
Then I'll let Mark talk about exactly what we're doing.
Yeah, I should just say we did Owning It and Growing It last
right.
year for businesses and for homeowners.
Absolutely.
And yeah, and that was just, you know, we didn't charge, but we exceeded our limit by like 3 times of the people we thought were going to come. So we're telling people for Empower You, we want you to sign up early. But go ahead, Mark.
Very successful
yeah.
sessions and very popular. And clearly what it speaks to is the need out there in the community to deliver this kind of information. And
right,
because so,
people are struggling. People have, even if you make a lot of money, even people who make a lot of money have a lot of debt and they're struggling and bill collectors. And I mean, it can be just a mess.
It can be overwhelming.
Yeah.
And it's surprising, really, the number of people who you think may have these concepts down that don't. And
right.
so we're here to make sure that we're focused on it and that we deliver it. And so for April of this year, which is Financial Capability Month,
yeah,
we have
that.
Partnered with the Herald and with the African American Chamber to deliver 4 sessions on 4 successive Saturdays. So we've got building your net worth.
Right.
We've got understanding your credit. We've got budgeting and savings. And then we've got understanding
investing.
In your investments.
Yeah. And that's so important, because once you get your credit score together
right.
and you learn how to budget, I mean, investing is really important, and people are afraid of that. People are afraid to invest because we don't always know, you know, how to choose the right investments and how much to put in. And I mean, that's a big area.
And so there was just an article I read yesterday around from Forbes around the difference in wealth building for African Americans and white or Latinos, and it was pretty startling, some of the gaps. And so we have to actually take that seriously and really be educated, engage each other, ask your friend the question. If you don't feel comfortable talking to an advisor, ask your friend who you see doing the right things.
Right.
But we have to get in the game, because we cannot all be Walmart greeters or
right. Right. That's right. We need to invest.
We want to live differently.
We need to invest. So let's talk about when it's going to be. It's April. It's every Saturday in April. April 7th, 14th, 21, 28.
Right. It'll be at the Mercy Health Complex, which is on Redding Road and Bond Hill, 1701 Mercy Healthplex Road. And we start out with slashing your debt. Mm-hmm. And we'll bring you concepts to understand, really, how you slash your debt, how you keep debt down.
That's going to be great. And it's only 2 hours.
9 to 11.
Come at 8:30 for breakfast, continental breakfast.
Yep.
We're not doing eggs and bacon. There'll be some food.
Yep.
So come at 8:30 for that. And you can sign up on Eventbrite, eventbrite.com, and then just search for Empower You, just the letter U, Empower You, and it's really easy. And it's totally free. And we appreciate you all doing that. I want to talk about the e-bus. Jeff said, what about that e-bus? We have a few seconds. Tell us
so
about that e-bus.
So we actually invested in a new mobile.
There it is.
It's called
right
the Empowerment Mobile. So if you all are used to the old e-bus, it was a traditional city bus. We actually now have a vehicle that has a tractor trailer that's retrofitted with computer stations, room for a workshop and classroom and privacy stations.
Oh, that's
it will be in the market in May and June in Dayton and Cincinnati.
Okay, so we will remind people about that, to tell them where to go to find it, because that's going to be really
you
exciting.
You should bring us back on the show for that.
Okay, let's come on back and talk about that. That'll be great. Okay, May and June. All right, good, for the e-bus. Okay, thank you so much. I'm sorry we're out of time. You guys will definitely be back soon.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, we've got Jen Henry here. She's going to tell you about some community events when we get back.
Okay.
Welcome back. We've got Jen Henry with some events you don't want to miss.
Yes, good morning. Here are some upcoming community events. The Shoe Dazzle Luncheon is Saturday, March 17th from 11 o'clock a.m. to 2 at the Embassy Suites Hotel. The tickets are $65, and for more info, call 513-818-9166. And the South Central Ohio Healthcare Supplier Diversity Symposium. That's Tuesday, April 10th from 7:30 a.m. to 3 o'clock p.m. at the Sharonville Convention Center. Registration is $50. You must register in advance. Reservation is 513-771-1718. And the 14th Annual Circle of Care Dinner and Silent Auction is Tuesday, April 10th at 6 o'clock p.m. at the Twin Towers, 5343 Hamilton Avenue. Tickets for that are $50. And for more information, call 513-300-4939.
Fantastic. And don't forget, Empower You, get on the path to financial fitness. You can go to thecincinnatiherald.com or just go to Eventbrite and look for Empower You. All right, so we want you to have a fantastic week. So many events, all that theater, so much to do. Stay safe and stay positive.
I want to see Dream Girls.